like you said, everyone, for breakfast show, you need to subscribe to Akada Kid Shopping Complex. I think it's the next big thing in Lagos State right now. All right, and right now on the set with us, we have Vina is back. Vera is back. Vina Vera. Wow, what a good combination. Vina Vera, Vera, Vina. Are you blushing, Vera?
Oh, right.
We have Dr. Adetola Akinpelu in the house with us this morning. He's from the Lagos State Primary Health Care Board. I'm correct?
Yes, you are.
Yes. And today we are looking at upcoming Lagos SIA and the importance of vaccination against vaccine preventable diseases. And I think our major focus this morning is on measles. Welcome.
Good morning to you.
Good morning.
Good morning. It's I'm glad to be here.
You need to speak out loud. All right, so we're looking at measles. So I think the first question I have there is, what is measles? That is, let's understand what measles is before we now go deep into it.
So measles is basically a viral illness, and it is transmitted via droplets. And that what that means is that when you sneeze, when you cough, if that person is currently having the measles infection and is contagious at that point in time, then you can easily spread it to the people around you. And it's carried by air.
Is that how measles spreads?
Okay. That's how it spreads.
Wow.
And it's also via droplets. Just like, you know, when we had the COVID, they tell you, wash your hands, don't touch surfaces. This droplet can also be on surfaces. So when a person coughs or sneezes and it drops, the person could have gone, but you are an unsuspecting person, you put your hand there, you transfer it to yourself.
So what are the symptoms? How are we going to know these symptoms?
So the measles symptom is, it has quite, I'll put it as, common symptoms, because symptoms will still have its fever, the runny nose, cough, headaches. But there's one thing that is very particular to measles, is a rash. And usually it's, that rash is specific to measles. So when you map merge all these symptoms with the rash, then it is measles until proven otherwise.
Okay. So when that unsuspecting person comes in contact with the droplet of that person, like, how long does it take before that person actually contracts measles?
So it takes roughly about 10 days before these symptoms start. But one thing is, it's not immediately you become symptomatic that you actually spread.
Okay.
But 4 days before the rash, 4 days after the rash, is when the person is, we put it as the, you can spread, that's when you spread this measles virus around.
Okay.
But for most, at that point when it's incubating, the person is not contagious. After the rash has cleared, the person is not contagious. But 4 days before you actually see that rash, then when you see the rash 4 days after, that is when the person is most contagious. And which is why when you go to schools, when you see a child with a rash, they'll tell you to isolate the child at home.
Mm.
So that you, because one of the easiest ways that it will spread is when you're in close contact. And children, of course,
they play, they hug,
they do everything together.
You know, I had an experience with my second daughter. During immunization, I think there's an immunization for measles maybe when they're 9 months. I don't know the exact month.
Yes, there is.
So I missed this. So when she was, she's what's it now? I think when she was 9, I saw this rash on her skin, and her eyes were red. And my mom asked me that, did you get the measles immunization? I said, I think I missed the thing. And I think at the age of 9, you can't get it again, I don't know. So, she had measles and it was really bad. In fact, she nearly went dumb, deaf. Yes, it's as bad as that. I'm telling you, I almost lost her. But I think God showed me mercy. I know God showed me mercy that I had my daughter back. So ever since then, I've been an advocate telling people do not miss those vaccinations. You know, I was told when I took her to the hospital, the doctor told me that assuming I got that vaccination for her, even though it will come, it will not be as
that bad.
Bad as this. So please, I want you to enlighten us on that. Because I have a personal experience.
So the ideal time for a child to get this vaccine is 9 months. And why 9 months is because earlier, when the child is still much younger, the child still has some of the maternal defenses in the body. So that gives some form of protection. But by 9 months, all that layer of protection would have eroded. So you need to now give the vaccine so that the body starts to generate its own defense. But then it's a two-dose vaccine, because when you take the first dose, it gives you just about 93% protection. And that means that there's still a 7% chance that that person can still have a complicated form of this disease. But the second dose now comes in 6 months after. So if you take the first dose at 9 months, by 15 months, the child gets the second dose. And that gives you the protection that you need. Now, I'm sure over the years, we've still heard of people still saying, oh, we're going to have a measles campaign, mm-hmm. we're going to go house to house, school to school to vaccinate children. Why we usually do this is because, unfortunately, Nigeria is still one of those countries where measles is endemic. And given certain circumstances, we tend to have frequent outbreaks, and we also tend to we are people that live in close quarters to each other. Mm. We are very personal people. We are not people that give each other space. So this tends to puts us at the risk of outbreaks. And once we're having these outbreaks, the best thing you can do is an outbreak response, where you vaccinate everybody. In fact, the target when you're doing an outbreak response to give you that herd immunity that will give you layers of protection for years to come in that entire society is when you vaccinate about 95% of the total population of children within the ages of 5 months and 59 months. Now that gives you that assurance, because that's also the age that spreads it the most. So once you can cover those ones, and those are also the ones that are most susceptible to the disease. They are the ones that tend to have the most complication, and they are the ones that tend to actually, these diseases result in death.
Okay, so how is he galvanized? How do you diagnose that?
So there are three layers of diagnosis. The first one is the clinical symptoms, which is the fever, just like I said earlier on, the cough and all that, and the sneezing. Then the next level is the clinical examination, which is still also done at the hospital. Then the final layer, which is the confirmatory test, is when you take the blood sample to the lab. And it's not just the regular lab where we just do maybe a regular blood checkup. There are viral labs that you take it to, that they do these viral assays to actually pick the case of measles. And with these layers, we've seen quite a number of measles cases in Lagos State and in Nigeria as a whole. And this is one illness that more often than not, the body would, you know, take care of it, because it's viral. And we know that viral illnesses can be self-limiting. The average Nigerian, when you fall ill, the first point of action is to go and take paracetamol, ibuprofen, vitamin C, malaria medication, and all sort of antibiotics. So yes, you may get that child may get well, and that diagnosis may not be made. If we actually get the real, if we actually are a community where for every illness we go through the due process of having a diagnosis, our measles burden will be extremely high.
Okay, so this measles, is it deadly? Is it deadly virus or disease or sickness?
It can be. And for most people that are non-vaccinated, or due to one reason or the other, immunity is it gives the person chances for the measles to become complicated. And complications include severe hearing problems, pneumonia, brain. The measles, the virus can actually travel to the brain and cause an infection of the brain. And of course, when it starts progressing like that, there's the possibility that the outcome will be death.
Talk to us about the treatment. How can one be treated if the person has results?
Let's go to
the first thing to do exactly.
So ideally, like I said, it's viral. So there's really no, take this medication, it works. But what we do is you manage the symptoms. If the person is having temperature spikes, you give something to relieve that. If the person is in pain, you give something to relieve the pain. When there's a rash, you give ointments to relieve the rash. That's the treatment. We expect that the body will build its own immunity to fight it, which is why it's imperative that you give that first point of protection to your child, which is the vaccines. By doing so, you're giving the body an opportunity to recognize that this is a measles virus, and once it sees it, it fights it. So that's where the vaccine comes into play. The body is already in a heightened sense, recognizing all these possible illnesses, which is why from birth we start to vaccinate against different vaccine preventable illnesses, because that is how the body can fight it.
I have to let you go because it's quite a very interesting topic, because I have a lot of questions to ask. Because some people will say when there is measles you don't take injection. I don't know how medically true that could be, but I don't know if you can quickly tell us that in the GFI, and again tell us about the upcoming campaign.
So, well, one of the major things that has been a bane, I would say, in the fight against eradicating measles is our myths and our cultural beliefs. When they tell you don't take injections, you have to bait the child with a certain leave and all that. But we do know that for a child that has measles, you manage the symptoms, you supplement with vitamins so that the body's immunity would keep and fight it, then you vaccinate. That's the best way to actually protect the child. So, which is why, as a state, we've looked at the trends. We've had several measles outbreaks. We've had several yellow fever cases in the state, and even in the country, you know, in general. And that puts us the fact that Lagos being a transmigratory state, where people are coming in from every state, you have to be proactive and protect. So we're rolling out a supplementary immunization campaign starting on the 19th of this month, and the sole aim is to protect all our children between the ages of 9 months to 59 months with the measles vaccine. Everybody in Lagos State, male or female, within the ages of 9 months to 44 years with the yellow fever vaccine. Then, if you remember quite well, last year we also did introduce the human papillomavirus vaccine into our routine immunization. But as of between last year and this year, all the girls that are within that coverage age, which is 9 years to 14 years, have not gotten this vaccine. So this is another opportunity
for them
to reach out to those girls that have not received last year to also get their vaccine.
So they can all go to their health center, community. Any health center in your community?
Every public health facility, inclusive of military, paramilitary, you have this. But also, because like I said, it's a campaign. And for yellow fever, for example, if you're going to vaccinate to get herd immunity, it means that we're vaccinating about 85% of Lagos State's population. So that means that we need to have people going out, because the hospitals will be overwhelmed. So we're going to have vaccination teams going to schools, going to churches, public areas, supermarkets, shopping malls, offices, where they can actually just have people have these vaccines at their own convenience.
And it's absolutely free.
It's absolutely free.
All right, thank you, Doctor. We appreciate you for coming on the show to enlighten us and to teach us. And for every parent, brother, sisters, aunt, uncle watching this morning, get that baby vaccinated, because this virus, this measles virus,
it's
real and it can be deadly. It can make a child go dumb or go deaf or blind. I'm telling you, I experienced it, but mercy, save me, God's mercy, save me. All right, that's how far we can go on the Bumper Breakfast Show this morning. We have Stanley Paul Ikawa in the house to give us sports updates. Thank you for joining in the program. To all the production team, well, thank you, we appreciate you. Thank you, and to all my co-hosts, thank you. And to our doctor for coming on air this morning to enlighten us and to educate us, thank you. My name is Teresa Adeyem. See you on the Bumper Breakfast Show tomorrow.
I am there also, but I'll see you.
And I am Vina Peters. I'll see you on Thursday.
Stanley Paul Ikawa joins us for Bumper Sports Update. Bye-bye for now.